What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another video today. This is going to be a small little unboxing, and then as things come in, I think in the next day or two, we got a couple things coming in, accessories for this thing, this monstrosity. We'll be talking about it. You're going to ask yourself a question. Oh, as I got on a knee to propose to you during this video, hey, will you give me a like and a follow? So this is Kobalt. I had a air compressor at one point before this. It was their like hot dog shaped or whatever it was called. It was an 8 gallon, much larger than this. I went to Lowe's and I was messing around. I was looking for an air compressor because I'm starting to get back into polish and paint. And I wanted to get a tornador. It's supposed to be tornado, but it says tornador, whatever they want to pronounce it as. I want to get one of those things, so I ordered that so I can clean like door jams and engine bay and whatever the heck I want to clean, actually. But whatever, that's for other videos. But I wanted one of those situations, and I wanted something to blow out the pads that would just be a little bit less of a headache until I could get to the actual pad cleaning. So I figured, all right, as long as it's above a 3 gallon, this is a 4.3, but this is what really got me. You can't really read it. We gotta go around the corner. Oh, Quiet Technology. I'm assuming that's what they wanted to put, but they just couldn't fit it on that little Vienna sausage sized thing there. It says up to 80% quieter. I don't know what they're comparing it to. I guess something comparable to this, but it is up to 80% quieter than whatever the heck it is. I looked around. The cool thing about this, all of the ones there pretty much did have the 150 max PSI. I don't think I'm going to need much more than that. The CFM and everything about this, you know, obviously the larger one would have benefited me better. When I get the new house, I'm going to have like a 20 plus gallon something in a corner or something. When I actually have the room for it, probably not far from now, but we're going to figure that out. So what's cool about this, like I said, the word quiet. I'm in this garage. It's not a huge garage, but it does well for me. It's what I get what I get out of it, and it works. When I'm doing something that requires a little bit more than the 4.3 gallons, as soon as it hits that limiter and it goes down and it has to refill, I don't want it to have to keep refilling, and it's like super loud. The other tank, it was just really obnoxiously loud. Having this with a quiet compressor, that really will make a difference. I'm hoping it works out. The other cool thing about Kobalt is they're very good with returns for Lowe's and warranty and anything like that. So I figured it's worth a shot. It's got a 3-year guarantee or whatever. Probably not even going to have it for that long. I had a gift card from Christmas. So this is usually like, what was it, $199 or $208 with tax or whatever. And I had like a $50 gift card. So it was $150. Comparable to like the $169 for the other thing that was a little bit more in size but didn't have the quiet. So I figured this was the way to go, and this is what we did. So let's open this up, let's just see what it looks like, and maybe get an idea of what it sounds like real quick. It says that 60 decibels, or I forget where, yeah, 60 decibels. I just so happen to have a decibel meter. I doubt there's a hose in here. I ordered a hose. I ordered coupler connectors and stuff. I ordered and a spray gun and stuff. So we'll see. Hopefully there's a hose in here. I doubt it. But let's open it up. You know, I just got to say, like, I cut it, right? You know, forget that, right? But as I'm cutting it, I didn't even open it yet. And I'm thinking to myself, damn, I really sure hope this thing doesn't have all that stupid foam, like, stuff inside that like flakes off and turns into 100,000 little tiny white balls all over the place. And then sure as shit, there it is. There it is. Damn. Oh, I hate that stuff so much. Oh, Maron. It's not good. This thing feels like it's got some good weight to it. I'm gonna tell you the reason why this was such a cool unit for me, not just for the compact size, but because the handle lifts up. It actually looks pretty cool. The only thing I don't love, the blue. Obviously, with a Kobalt product, that's what you're stuck getting. See? Shrapnel. It's like a bullet wound in a video game, and then you just start bleeding out all over the place. That's what that is. Is it all over my floor? No. So I'm gonna have to tighten these. These should not be loose like that. But other than that, this is kind of cool. It could be rolled. It's nice. And then, when I'm done, I can just store it anywhere. These clips open up like that, and this folds down, then you tighten it back up. Like I said, I have to tighten that anyway. It looks like a cool little unit. It's actually a good size. I think it's a looker. I do. It's got like a double hot dog whammy thing going on here. Very familiar layout to what happened. What is this? Okay. Very familiar layout to the other tank, the 8-gallon, obviously made by the same company. That's how you turn it on and off. That's cool. And then, like I said, the lines, I ordered new couplers and everything. Here's that one valve that you can... Well, that's not good. Why was there air? There shouldn't have been air in there, I guess. That was in there from their last testing. So it tells you tank pressure, and then it tells you tool pressure, and you can adjust that this way. So if you want to increase tool pressure or whatever, go down. I can't really do anything with this. I can plug it in and turn it on, but that's what we're going to have to just do. Get an idea of what the decibel is. I have 2 decibel meters. So we're going to, I guess, plug this in and let this fill up the tank. I like this. It's got like a little thing to wrangle the power cord. That's pretty cool. Little things like that I appreciate. Just got to make sure that the bottom of the tank was locked. We're going to leave this the way it is. And let's see what we could do. I'm going to turn that on. Alright, so I guess as it levels down, it's going to go to like 30, 40. They're saying 60. There's no chance that it's 60. No chance. I don't know how loud this is actually going to be, but we're going to find out right now. Kind of sort of what I figured it was going to be, a little bit louder than their claims, but then again, ambient noise in here probably isn't necessarily helping anything. This is actually very quiet, so I'm going to let it go to like 90 psi. It goes up to 150, remember that. I've seen other reviews as tanks start filling up more. It gets louder because the compressor has to work harder to fill up what's ever left over. This is not a bad noise at all. I can literally talk over this noise. The other one was much louder, significantly louder. That is surprisingly quiet compared to the 8-gallon version that I had. Like I said, the hot dog version with the big tank. I mean, they both look cool, but this obviously looks cooler. Also, I guess they have some kind of baffling thing done to it. Whatever they did, they did a good job. Honestly, they did a good job. It's very quiet. Now, when I have this out, it's going to be plugged in. If I have the cord, for whatever reason, I'm detailing something or messing around cleaning pads or cleaning door jams, doing anything, engine bay work or filling my tires with air, anything that I would need to do on a daily basis, or not even necessarily a daily basis, on a weekly basis, on a bi-weekly basis, every few week basis, whatever that is, it's good to have this. It's good to have this. It's holding pressure. And like I said, it's a Kobalt product, so I'm not worried. Warranty would be pretty fine. I wish I might want to paint this. I'm not really a fan of the blue, like I said, but you're stuck with the blue handles. So with this, you turn this, and it'll start putting pressure for the tool as you turn it. So if I want to get to, for instance, so say I have a tool that needs 90 PSI. So I leave it on there. I know I have more than 90. You can only have as much PSI for the tool as you have in the tank. So I think most stuff that I'm going to use this for is like probably 60 to 100, I would assume. I haven't, again, used many attachments in the past. It's once I get a larger tank with higher PSI, as I grow with my needs, I'll have a necessity for that. But for right now, this is good. And then if you want to bleed it out, you can do that. That just scared the hell out of me because I wasn't expecting it to lock open. Or you can just turn this thing. And it'll just start draining. Again, I'm not a pro with any of this stuff, but from what I've been told in the past, you always want to make sure you don't let like air stay in the tank, stuff like that, because it could get water in your lines and whatnot. So, yeah, that's where we're at. I'm gonna pause this here, and when I resume in a split second, we're gonna have some attachments to go over, and possibly be able to do a demonstration. I'll show you what hose I ordered, the fittings. It's gonna be a mismatch of colors, but I guess I'm not really worried about the hose now. I did get a Flexzilla or whatever it was. It's kind of like that color. It's more green. That's yellow. So now I'm gonna have very much OCD problems with this machine. We've got red. We've got blue. We got black. We got yellow. We're gonna have green. We got brass. This is just all kinds of colors. Oh, whatever. But if it works, it works. I'm very excited. It's very quiet. Let's check out the accessories. Okay, so some of the stuff finally arrived. What we ended up going with here was the Flexzilla. Legacy makes it, I guess, this company. I did a 25-foot setup here. I would consider a 50, but honestly, since that's on wheels and it's very easily maneuverable, I feel like having 25 feet is extremely adequate for this garage. What we also went with were these connectors here. Focus, there we go. So we got green, and then I'll show you here, right here, which I'm hoping seems like they lock in nice. My issue is I had to change a couple things. So that was the blowgun thing that I had last time. And I'm going to have to change this if everything works. So essentially what I'm going to do now is just have that plugged in. We're going to have this already filled up. So we're going to increase our tool pressure, which I should start feeling air going through the hose now. Yeah, that definitely stiffened up the connection. I'm going to keep it at like 70, 80 PSI. So I like the hose. The hose feels decent. I did order swivel attachments, so I might end up using those, but let's see. Yeah. Whoa, right in my face. This is serious. Pretty good and pretty dang strong. And this is the actual tank pressure, so it was at 150. It's gonna be good. And then the refill sound is really not that serious. Let me hook this up here and see what's going on. I wish I knew what happened here with this. I'm gonna have to return this. I thought this was gonna be cool. But it's not working with this threaded piece here. I would have to have the one it came with, and this is not going to work with these. So that's unfortunate. But I mean, honestly, for what I need to blow a pad out, this is going to be totally fine. And the good thing is these are like rubber coated tips. So God forbid I ever need to like get anywhere in a jam or something, I know I'm not gonna have to worry about this banging into the paint, and it's got the hook which can't hook anywhere. So that's not ideal. But Draper-Rooney, gotta love it. And here we go. That's the other connector that we got. It's actually kind of cool. I'll be able to, I guess while it's connected, it's going to tell me how much PSI is in the tire, but I have my own special one over there that I use. But it's pretty cool. This thing's kind of cool. Watch. So these are what I was talking about. It's a 14-piece coupler / plug kit by ColorFit. They have a couple other colors. I was going to go with just like a black color. It's a pretty cool setup. I can do the tire air. I can do the compressor air. I can maybe run like a smaller little pneumatic sander to polish things if I start messing around with that carbon fiber skinning stuff. We'll see how that goes. But anyway, that's what we got. This is pretty cool. It's very quiet. I'm excited. I think if I did this, yeah, it's going to fill it back up to 150, but this is really not a ton louder than like talking noise. I showed you already before this the decibel reading. It fills up very quick, very solid, sturdy. I'm excited. Obviously the main test is going to be is this going to last, but it's a Kobalt product. I have confidence. Now watch this. The first time I heard this, this kind of made two drops of pee come out. I wasn't expected to have a Toyota Supra twin turbo blow off valve go off here, but watch. Like shifted into a new gear. It scared the crap out of me before. But yeah, that's it. And I did tighten these bolts. It wasn't too much. You can't even push anything on it, or you know, it locks in nice and sturdy the way it's supposed to. You can lift the unit if you want, lower it down. It's a pretty compact setup. I think anybody that has like a small garage setup is gonna want this. Like I said, when I get the new garage, after we're done designing everything, finding the lot to build the house on and all this other stuff, I'll have like a bigger tank. I'm assuming one like that tall. Something that I could, you know, basically run any tool for any reason and just have it there. So that's the goal, you know. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for stopping by. If you are new to the channel, please consider subscribing and hitting that notification. If you are an OCD OG, I truly appreciate you. Thank you so much for your support. Thank you. Hope everybody's doing well. Hope everybody's staying happy, healthy, humble. I'll see you guys on the next one.